Expectations are things that we deal with on a daily basis throughout our lives, whether they be the expectations of other people or even ourselves. These expectations can be for the future or present, but they're often prevalent in our lives. Expectations are goals that we set, often wanting to achieve something great through them. Petgrelf Sakurasawa expresses these goals and expectations in a realistic way through its characters rather than conforming to set cliches. Petgrelf Sakurasawa shows the viewer these characters that have their own goals, their own expectations of themselves on top of the ones set by those around them, and how they work towards said goals, living up to the expectations. I used the term realistic earlier because these characters don't all succeed. The story isn't one of friendship trumping all or of hard work prevailing. The characters fail to achieve their goals as they constantly see more talented people around them succeed easily. The theme that the Petgrelf Sakurasawa tries to convey isn't one of treasuring your youth, valuing your relationships, or any other theme commonly found in coming-of-age stories. Rather, it attempts to tell the viewer that despite how far they've strayed from their original goals, they should be content with where they are and continue doing what makes them happy, making do with what they're given rather than dwelling on what could have been through their observations of other people. The story of the Petgrelf Sakurasawa starts out like many others, with the main character, or at least the character that we see the most of throughout the story, Sorta Kanda, being introduced as someone unique. Kanda was placed in a dorm room called Sakura Hall because he wanted to adopt a cat but couldn't bring it into the normal dorms. To remedy the situation, he was placed into a dorm room outside of the standard ones, which resembles a large house more so than dorms. Sakura Hall is home to many peculiar people with peculiar ambitions. Excluding Kanda, Sakura Hall was home to many talented people that didn't necessarily fit into the normal dorms. Of these unique residents, Shina Mashiro was no exception, being a talented mangaka who was already famous and successful. Despite Shina having done nothing wrong, she as well as Akasaka almost serve as antagonists in the story for some of the other Sakura Hall residents due to how talented they are. These two characters can be considered antagonists because of how talented they are. Kanda attempts to live up to the expectations and standards of those around him by trying to pick up a hobby and attempting to work. Akasaka, one of the residents of Sakura Hall, is a programming prodigy. Taking interest in programming and thinking that Akasaka could teach him, Kanda pursues this. He works to better his skills with occasional help from Akasaka. He works tirelessly to produce a beta for a game, enlists Shina in creating character design, and finally submits it to some companies, only for his efforts to be for naught. He gets many interviews, but none of the companies want to hire him or take on his game. Instead, many of them ask him who did the cover art and character designs because they'd like to hire them instead. Shina never intended for this to be the case, nor does she take pride in it, but her talent is something of an antagonist to Kanda, someone who is putting in so much effort to even be considered equal to her and Akasaka, only to have his efforts thrown back in his face. Throughout the show, Kanda's pride is beaten down again and again, leading him to feel as though he has no future, because he can't succeed regardless of how much effort he puts in. Similarly to Kanda, Nanami Aoyama is attempting to achieve her goals through effort and sheer hard work. She's run away from home in pursuit of voice acting, and after not having been able to afford the dorm's rent, she moves into Sakura Hall. But unlike Kanda, Nanami can be considered talented. Nanami is a great voice actress without luck. She's tied down by her lack of income, which severely affects her ability to voice act, despite the thought that anything can be achieved through hard work. How is Nanami, a minor who is already working a part-time job, can barely afford dorm rent and enough food, supposed to travel long distances for auditions that likely won't be fruitful? Shina also serves as an antagonist for Nanami because she seemingly doesn't need to try. She gets taken care of by those around her, works at her own leisure, and is naturally gifted at her unorthodox ambition. Again, Shina doesn't attempt to be the villain, but her being talented results in her being envied, if not even disliked, by those around her, who seemingly put in more effort than her. Kanda and Nanami may not be successful in their endeavors, but it's hard on even those who are. Misaki Kamigusa and Jin Mikata are both talented and are recognized for their works. Misaki being an animator and Jin being a scriptwriter. Their struggles aren't ones that relate to their ambitions, but ones that relate to their happiness. These two are older than the other Sakura Hall students and are going to graduate soon during the show. Their struggles revolve around the choices they have to make. They need to either go their separate ways, pursuing their ambitions and hope that life brings them back together in the future, or they can stick together through it all, risking the loss of what they dream of. Their choice may seem simple, but this choice is a hard one. Their love is genuine, but so is the love for their work that they do, which is made evident through their attempts at making every moment last during their last year at Soccer Hall. They don't really have an antagonist other than time itself, because they're a part of the talented few at Soccer Hall. They're used to show that even those who are talented have choices to make, have struggles, and have to give up on things that they can't accomplish, rather than having their life filled with ease that they can swiftly maneuver through. I've been using Shina and Akasaka as antagonists for the other residents of Soccer Hall, but these talented characters have their own struggles. These struggles may not be seen to be of the same level of the other characters, but they're struggles nonetheless, and they're ones that are also present within our world. Shina, having little issues with her work, instead suffers from her lack of emotion and common sense. She doesn't understand others and their struggles easily because she seemingly believes in the potential of those around her. She succeeded, so it makes sense to her that her friends, who she holds in high regard, would also succeed. This can be considered a struggle because it results in her lack of empathy for people, furthering her role as a talented person on a completely different level compared to the other characters. Akasaka, similarly to Shina, experiences little empathy towards those around him, but for different reasons. Rather than not being able to understand them, he prefers to be direct and frank with people rather than sugarcoat anything. This results in people's disliking for him, which eventually led to his wariness of other people. Being shunned by those around him for his harsh yet accurate criticisms, he is seen to do the same now in an attempt to avoid the occurrences of the past. He's a soft person who distances himself in an attempt to not hurt himself and those around him. The Pet Girl of Sakura Sao uses this mixture of talented and untalented characters to attempt to portray some of the struggles within real life. Rather than having a happy ending in which the characters struggle towards, Sakura Sao has its characters struggle towards seemingly nothing because the characters themselves are not talented. Something commonly shown in other shows is the success of the main characters through their hard work, but that's an optimistic view on life. Although many things can be achieved through hard work, talent or lack thereof can't be disregarded. Someone more talented in a field will have an easier time in said field, while the opposite is true. Sakura Sao's characters are deliberately made to be both talented and untalented to show the difference between them, to show just how much someone must really struggle, to show how the real world isn't one similar to fiction where fate has its way of giving everyone a happy ending. It attempts to show that regardless of how much you try, it won't always work out in your favor in the end because there are more talented people than you are. This form of storytelling is a unique one. It's not present in many other shows and is done surprisingly well for how unorthodox it is. Despite their differences in the types of struggles that they harbor, the residents of Soccer Hall are friends, if not almost family. Despite one's shortcomings or one's success, they care for each other and push each other to better themselves. The author attempts to show the sadness of life as one reaches the age of maturity, but he doesn't purposefully pin the world against these characters, which is evident through the end of the show. The ending of the show, despite being somewhat vague, gives us, the viewers, a general idea of what became of our characters. Kanda, failing within the programming industry, at first continued to work, and although he hasn't achieved the same level of success as Akasaka, he's been a part of the creation of smaller games, making steady progress on his goal. Similarly to Kanda, Nanami hasn't become someone famous, but she's made progress, continuing to push through in an attempt of achieving her goals. Jin and Misaki ended up choosing the more difficult path of putting their ambitions aside for each other, getting married and moving into the house beside Sakura Hall after graduation. Lastly, Shina and Akasaka continue to work on what they're good at, achieving their own goals and ambitions within their fields. Attempting to portray real life, real emotions, and real relationships isn't something new to anime, but The Pet Girl of Sakura Sao is one of the only shows that I've seen which has actually portrayed the struggles of life, while still having a satisfying and unexaggerated ending. The characters aren't necessarily happy with the outcome of their lives, but they're at least content, which is what I believe to be the essence of real life, being content rather than happy. As I said, Hajime Kamoshida's attempt to display the real world through his work didn't go unnoticed. There are countless people that sing nothing but praise for not only the Pet Girl of Sakura Sao, but also his other works, and rightfully so. Kamoshida has created a story that accurately represents the coming of age genre without falling into common stereotypes and cliches. Overall, this story is one that is deserving of the praise it receives and is one that, despite its popularity, can still be considered underrated. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please consider liking and subscribing.